Pribhumi means native, but it's also translated like the first creature from the earth. I made this Pribhumi Pribhumi performance where I used food as a way of communication. What happened is actually that in May 98, the Suharto government started to use a lot of violence to create chaos in the hope that they can take over power again. They went against the ethnic Chinese people living in Indonesia. Yeah, many shops went into fire, they were burned down, women got raped, and all kinds of horrible things happened in that time. So the story of what really happened to those people came out like 3 months after the riots and after Suharto resigned finally. I decided to make a performance on the street and to open up a dialogue about what happened to the Chinese people living in Indonesia. I used frog legs because it's a Chinese food and it's unclean for Indonesian Muslims, so it's dominant Muslim religion in Indonesia. So I asked also my white friends, my foreign friends, we also a small ethnic group, to fry the frog legs with me and to serve them to the public. Yeah, I had like maybe say 200 frog legs and they were all eaten in the end. Because Indonesian people are very open-minded and they, how do you say it? It's an oral culture, so people like to talk. So nobody is shy, you know, they just get close to you and they ask, what is this for? So there were many people ask questions, there were many discussions going on. So we were sitting there with the seven of us and while doing the frying, these dialogues happened. I think, yeah, also by eating a meat that you're not familiar with, I think it's part of how you try to understand more of that culture. So, for example, I did another performance with food in Queensland, in Canberra, when I had an exhibition there. I made four cloaks out of different animal skins. And then at the same time, I also created kitchens with four different meats. And then I prepared all kinds of herbs from all over the world. And I just asked the international audience to cook with me. So the Chinese and the French, they started to fry the frog legs. And it was eaten by people who never tried it before. There was kangaroo meat cooked by the Australians and the Aboriginals. So, yes, all those kinds of things happen. Yeah, you can use food as a starting point to understand another culture.